And hello again, everybody. My opponent for this game will be Elano Bison, or Elano Bison, Bison, Elano Bison. That will be doing just fine. And he has 328 games and 173 wins. And hello again, and welcome to Delta Quadrant. I'm spawning in the top right position here as Lord Priest, the Red Zerg, in this matchup, and I am against the Terran player Elano Bison, the Blue Terran. And this game is not only for some enjoyment, some analysis, it's also to point out something that I do struggle with a lot myself. Maybe some other players do that as well, and I will try to give some kind of advice to handle hard pressure situations. I will do my best, of course it will not be like J9 or say StarCraft or anything like that, but I will do it as good as possible. And as you can see, I'm going out there, I'm scouting, I want to see where he is. I'm flying down my overlord here. It's I always fly it clockwise if I fly over here. I want to scout his ramp. I have a long way to get out of land areas. This way I can park it right here and just fly in and out quite easily. And I'm getting down my drone here, we'll see where he is. Pretty soon he's getting his barracks, and what am I doing? I'm getting my gas. And I am getting my spawning pool, I would assume. This is not the game directly after the last cast. I'm casting them right after each other, but I played the game one game between these two games, and of course that was a horrible, horrible match. Everything went wrong, and then I was proxy rushed, and I was killed, and I was ashamed, felt quite dirty, and then I needed a long shower to feel as a human again. And once again I'm just running around here in this base, being annoying, and in the meantime I'm getting gas, I'm getting a spawning pool, and I am scouting some more. And as you can see, he's getting his marine out here. I do see that, and let's see how I react in my ordinary way. Hello, gas. Once again, I shut down any gas heavy builds early on, and he's scouting me to see where I am and what I'm up to. And as you can see, I'm getting a like, unit's production tab, I'm getting my first set of servants, I'm getting my queen, I'm getting my speed, and... Yeah, I was wondering where I got a gas, and of course that is over here, and I redid it, cancel, and built a new one. Should be able to be annoying as much as possible, and he's getting two marines out. In comparison to the other guy, last match, he got four marines so early on. And of course I let it finish, that was annoying. But I'm chasing him away here, and of course I'm chasing him to his base. And I'm like, hello, you are getting a factory. That's not very pleasant. And I'm getting Roach Warren. As you can see, as soon as I saw that factory, I suspect Hellions or some kind of tank or mech play. Of course you could go for the 1-1-1 build early on and do some kind of job harass. But I cannot gear up to be able to stay alive against that only, of course. I do prefer to... And it felt like, yeah, he's going mech. I don't know why, but that was my feeling. Yeah, this is the Chell. I'm running up there. Now I remember. I see a Czech lab, and I'm like, okay, that is strange. He's getting his Hellion out as well, but as you can see, he's getting a barracks there. No starport so far. I'm getting my natural, which is always annoying, but I got some surgeons going down there to kill the debris. I'm injecting, getting my second gas to be able to get even more gas to be able to sustain more roaches or even mutalisks or hydras in the future. The roaches are mainly for just staying alive long enough in this game to be able to do something funny later on. And it's not much going on. He's getting his infernal pre-igniter, which makes blue flame Hellions. And they are really strong. And it's hard to deal with them with only Zerglings. It works if you have a lot and get a good surround, but they deal a lot of damage. But not against Roaches. They have nothing to do against Roaches. Roaches really crush them. As you can see, getting this down, I'm getting my expansion up, getting a queen. And I do have quite a lot of workers here. We're both at 27. But he can use his mules every now and then, and that keeps him slightly ahead. I'm getting out one roach. I have some more down here. I do some poking every now and then. I do see more and more Hellions. And I should do a transfer here pretty soon. Come on, you can do it. There we go. It's maybe a few too many, but I think I will do okay. I'm getting even more roaches. Because I saw that he was moving around here with his Hellions, and I'm like, okay. I don't want to play that game if you look at unit stab. And once again, I am not producing anything, because I'm so broke on minerals due to that heavy transfer. But now I mine pretty evenly here. I'm getting a spine crawler, getting one drone and two overlords. As usual, as you can see, I'm capped as always. And he's moving in here, but I do feel quite secure. I want to avoid him running in this way. I should probably keep like 3 or 4 roaches there to block, and keep the others in the mineral line. And I'm checking here. I see that he doesn't mine here, but he's going for the job because he got his starport finally. And I don't think I see this on the all way around. No, he's going quite good way, and it keeps me from seeing it. Or if he went close to this, I missed it in this game. And there we have Oscar Herdenben, very online. You saw him in the 3v3. Yes, Stig Hedvig. And he's running around here with the Hellions, doing nothing. I'm joining up as much as possible, getting even more roaches. Now I'm seeing this drop, and I'm like, oh, this is not good. And he's going for the two front assault. He's dropping in the back, and he's going, of course, in with his Hellions in front. But I have one queen, two spank rolls. I got some roaches here, and here you will see a huge lack of control. He's moving in here, but I'm able to chase him up there, but somehow I missed something in my main. I moved in with a couple of Zerglings. One survived here. You can tell the tale later about all his friends, his brothers, just evaporating to this marine force. I'm going in and try to deal as much damage as possible, but I cannot really kill this. I should get a new queen, and of course, if you look at the units now, I'm down to 16. Harvester, she's on at 32, but still I'm on 2 bases, on 1 base, and she's trying to drop once again. I'm trying to keep him away from my base, and this of course forced me to drone up heavily again. As you can see, I'm getting 6 6 drones. I'm getting a spine crawler here. When he drops, if he wants to drop here, I can attack him, get some kind of defense at least. I had almost finished spire there, it died. That was annoying, but I'm getting a new one down here, which he will not be able to see. It's a bit more secure. Maybe she gotten that there from the beginning. I'm trying to drone up as heavily possible, getting 7 more there. Just hatches, going up here, send them all up here to my mine at my main again. My queen is almost up, and I'm trying to inject, getting as much lore as possible. He's getting his expansion right now. He's not using his mules, he probably is going to mule down here heavily, you would assume. And once again he's moving out here with his force, which is not that it's not that huge. Of course you can pin down with some siege tanks out in the outskirts. You can shoot in and it's hard to break, and we'll see how this will work out. Because if you look at it now, we just take it short miniatures and pause the game. If you look at this, the units, it doesn't tell that I was so far behind. I did feel a lot of pressure. I killed a lot of drones, a lot more than he should have. But as you can see, if you wait a while, that is when you can determine, am I ahead or am I behind. And this roach force, I had it all the time. And He didn't have this. He's building have been building these since, and got his expansion since that attack that did so much damage to me. And of course, I felt behind right now. Right back then, I was probably behind. But you cannot only count one thing. You cannot look at, okay, I have more units. That tells me that I am ahead or behind if you have less. You cannot only look at the Jones. You need to look at everything. I had less Jones, but I had two expansions. Not two expansions, but two bases. I can produce a lot more. I can get my income up quite nice. And if you look at this now, I'm having 35 Jones. He's having 35. Harvesters as well, his SCVs there. So we have exact same number. He's having quite nice forces. He got some tanks, some marauders, and some marines. But it's not a huge force. So got his dropships back there as well. Got some medevacs here. But if you look at it now and didn't know what happened earlier, and this is something, of course, I have taken from day 9. Look at this moment. And as you can see, he's getting expansion. He's having an expansion. I have an expansion. Mine is a bit more saturated down here. He's just starting to kick in. Getting my spire. Nothing really going on down here. And I break these rocks as well. If you look at it as at this way, you cannot actually see that I was so far behind on harvesters. If we continue this game, we will see how this will end up, of course. And when I played this game, I was like, okay, he did a lot of damage. Okay, now it's lag again. He did a lot of damage, but how will I come back from it? And can I come back from it? It's hard to just try to play the same game that he's doing. But it did feel like, okay, I probably am not so far behind as I think overall. Of course, at the count of harvesters, I was behind and I knew that. But other than that, I was quite okay, and as you can see now, we are about the same. I'm getting out my Mutalisks. Of course, they are great at against Terran. Not against Marines, of course, but Marauders, Tanks, Medivacs. I'm moving out here because they are stupid. I'm running back here. I don't want to fight against these tanks, they deal a lot of damage. So I'm trying to produce as much units as possible. There are a lot of Zerglings, getting more Roaches. He's waiting for his plus one, of course. It's not good to attack just before it finished, but if he moves in. And this is something that I doesn't like. He moves over the creep here with his dropship. I can see this. And this is what happens if you fight someone with Mutalisks. And I can move in here, I see this tank, and I'm like, hello. And he is having, he had 8 marines in that, so he's only having a few marines down here. I'm like, I'm going to kill them. I'm taking this fight, and he's moving in here. And I move in with my force here, and can kill this tank easily, I can kill this really, really easy. And as you can see, the tide has turned a lot. Okay, of course, he kills my expansion, but look at this, I have my third up. Which is now my second, and I can rebuild this quite easily. I didn't lose that much. I'm getting 4 more drones. And there's nothing he can defend with. Okay, this is laggy. He can't really defend out here right now. He's getting some loose marines. He's getting his medevacs here. And I'm getting... what is that? I'm getting 2 hatcheries? Yeah, I'm getting this one as well. I thought, why not getting a 4? Taking my natural going in there. These Mutalisks are not great positioned here, but they move away. And I force him to bring out his SCVs. If you look at the units right now, his SCV count is dropping rapidly. And suddenly I am ahead in everything. In forces, in workers, in everything. So, it's the point of this game is to show the importance of keeping the cool, and he's not even giving a GG. I think I deserve that from the defense, even though he did unnecessarily much damage down here. And that was everything for this game. I hope some of you can take some knowledge from it. And, and of course, if you see a drop, make sure you kill it. Do not let it deal more damage than necessary. Some damage is will happen, but he killed my whole mineral line and one my spire, of course, and that was annoying. And that was everything for today. Thank you and goodbye.